A little bit of Ohio players. Here on KUHSDenver.com, 102 p.m. in the Mile High City, Denver, Colorado. It's a little bit of snow here. It's not like that out in Fort Lauderdale, Florida. We're going to take a little bing-bing down there. We're going to stream into Fort Lauderdale with, of course, Emmanuel, like we promised you. Ohio players, sweet sticky thing. We're going to dial this back a little bit and kind of turn them down while we get busy. We're going to go live right now. We're going live, so check it out. You can also watch this on www.kuhsdenver.com if you don't have social media. No excuse, because we do have a widget built into our website, which is a TV screen, and you can watch it live there too. But right now, we got in the background, that's right, Emmanuel. I'm going to take off my headsets and get busy talking to her, so stick around, hang with me. Are you ready, girl? Emmanuel? Are you ready?
I am ready.
Okay, you're live.
Already.
We're streaming live,
yes.
Yeah. Okay, Emmanuel Sassoon, live with me here at KUHSDenver.com. And you're 18 years old. You're recently graduated high school. You're having a breakthrough year, they say. You're from South Florida based you're a multi-instrumental, a singer-songwriter, and first major mark in 2019. Is that correct?
Yes, sir, that is correct.
Now, your EP accumulated over 50,000 streams on Spotify. You must be doing well with what you're doing. So this EP started Emmanuel on a journey that took her across the country, opening for artists such as Stephen Kellogg, Tyrone Wells. Emmanuel's live shows have made her a household name in Florida. Emmanuel, let's talk to the audience and tell us, what do you feel about this EP and how it's doing for you?
Well, I wrote this EP many years ago, when I was 14 years old, I started writing it. And it has really changed my life. It has put everything into perspective. The first song I ever wrote, Cage, is actually on that EP. So I'm very proud of how it came out, and I'm very happy that people are listening to it and enjoying it.
That's nice. And you are a solo singer-songwriter, is that right?
Yes, that is correct.
Now, do you ever play with other instrumentalists with you? Do you have backups? Do you have other people playing with you?
Well, currently right now, I'm actually working on getting a live band for my shows, because I always play solo, but when it comes to recordings, I play all of the instruments except for drums. I hire a drummer, and pretty much everything else is on me.
Okay, you've got that song, Away From Me. Is that the title name of the song?
Yep.
Okay, so what made you come up with that?
So, it was last January, and I was actually going through a pretty dark period of time, and I needed to let go of some things, and the song was basically stream of consciousness. I wrote it in about 20 minutes.
Wow.
And, it's just about letting go of certain parts of myself, and really, you know, how I battle with depression. And I think mental health is a very important topic, and it's not spoken about enough. So that song, pretty much. And yeah.
And a lot of people don't understand that, you know. Some people take care of their mental health by really being stressed. Stress is a big problem in this world, and I think a lot of people run, work out. You do it with music and how to convey and project what you feel through your music. And you said within a few minutes you developed this song because it was right there ready for you. Now, there's something that you did down in the NBA halftime show at American Airlines Arena down there. With Miami, with the Miami Heat, you did, what, a six-song performance?
Yeah, I did a 15-minute performance. It was about six songs at the American Airlines Arena. They had a plaza outside. It was a really, really fun show, and I really enjoyed it. I met a lot of cool people.
Did you have that recorded? Did you make sure and get a lot of pictures, live feed? Of course
yes,
you did, Emmanuel.
I have a lot of pictures and videos.
Yeah, so it's like, that's good stuff. Those are memories that you can just look back on and
yeah.
Say, was that really me? You know, and so
mm-hmm.
What inspired you? I mean, you're 18. That's not very much time to develop your musical career unless you started when you were young.
Well, I started playing instruments when I was younger. I started songwriting when I was 14, and that's when I started writing the Smoke and Mirrors EP. And I used to have a vocal coach, and I used to write poetry as well, and my first vocal lesson with her, she sat me down. She was like, "Oh, you write poetry?" I said, "Yeah." She goes, "Have you ever tried turning your poetry into songs?" And I said, "No." And she goes, "Okay, I'm going to leave the room. You have 10 minutes to write a song. Go." And then I just needed that push. I needed that head start. And I, after 10 minutes, I wrote a horrible song, but I wrote something. And it kind of inspired me to keep going. And ever since then, I haven't stopped writing songs. So
that's interesting because, okay, so can I ask you to do just maybe one line of poetry? Something you wrote, just do a couple of lines. Let's hear what that sounds like. You can do that? Do you have anything from your collection? Come on, Emmanuel. You got
I have not written straight up poetry in such a long time.
But I mean, you've converted something to songs, and now you're writing a song.
Yeah.
And so it's coming out so cool.
I can give you an example.
Yeah, that's
like
what I'm looking for.
Existing song. Well, in an existing song, like in Smoke and Mirrors, that was a poem first, and then it turned into a song. So I think the first few lines I wrote from that song was, everybody always asks me, "Oh, how'd you get so cold?" If I'm being honest, honestly, I don't know. Maybe if I wasn't so insecure, there would be way more open doors, but they took the key and left me lying on the cold, hard floor. I think those were like the first few lines, and then I just built the rest of the song, and there was no melody.
It was just words, and then you put the melody line
yeah.
in. And so is it up tempo? Because it's a different type of song, right? Is it more up tempo?
Yeah, it's pretty up tempo for the lyrics. Yeah, for sure. So
that's nice.
I always like to contrast like very melancholy, like very sad lyrics and put like a really up tempo song. Yeah.
That's lit.
I love doing that.
Yeah, so now you named it Smoke and Mirrors for a reason.
Mm-hmm,
what? What? There was something inside of you that said this would be a perfect title for my EP.
Well, it's kind of I wouldn't say maybe like paradox, or it's contradicting the whole theme of the album, because Smoke and Mirrors is something that is like covering up the truth, and the whole album is the truth because it's like. People, especially when I was younger, they tend to like assume things about me, and they didn't really know much about my music or what I actually was trying to, the messages that I was trying to convey in my songs. And I thought it was kind of funny how nobody really knew what I was trying to say. Nobody let me talk. So that whole album is me just like telling my truth, and then Smoke and Mirrors is like I named it that because it's the complete opposite. It's kind of hard to explain.
No, I got it. Everybody's getting it. No, you're explaining it perfectly. Now, you know, they compared me to Billie Eilish. You know, she's really good. I really like the color of her hair. You've got the same kind of a similar, not, I can't say similar look, but you got the color of the hair, and you've got that kind of a, you're portraying it, but she's hit it big with a lot of her stuff, too. So, why do they compare Billie Eilish and you? I mean, there's a point in, because I did hear some of the songs, I thought, wait a minute, it sounds like a bike, but it's not, it's you.
Mm-hmm. Well, it's funny because I found out about Billie Eilish way before she got famous, and after I started writing, so it was like a year after I started writing, I found Billie Eilish, and people started comparing me to her because I guess my age, I guess I'm young, I'm a young songwriter, she's a young songwriter, and I can see like a little bit of the comparisons, I guess, in the persona, but in terms of music, that's just up to the listener.
Yeah, she
had
a couple of nice songs there. Yeah, you're right. But your songs are just as compelling and nice on the same
Thank
note.
You.
On the same note. I mean, if anybody wants to hear this stuff, and I'll get some ready, but we'll keep talking while I get a couple of your songs ready, and I'm going to let them roll inside the studio here. Now, tell us more. You got Smoke and Mirrors. I'm going to put that one in about 2 minutes. I'll put that on in 2 minutes. So we'll talk some more, and I'll get Smoke and Mirrors on there for you. Okay? So
awesome.
I got that ready to go. So, okay, you have some plans into the future. Do you have any gigs that are coming up that you want to share with everybody?
Well, I did, and then unfortunately, the whole coronavirus.
Oh, yeah, I forgot.
Things are getting canceled.
You know, I'm in here, I'm all having fun, I forget out there. It's like everything's crazy.
I was supposed to play some shows. I was supposed to go back to the studio to finish up the second album, and it's like now all those things are canceled.
Everything's
but I'm waiting for things to reschedule and get back to normal, you know, staying home. So.
Yeah, this to me, I really believe they're just resetting the financial markets. That's how it just seems. I don't know why. Because a lot of people die every year of alcoholism about 80 times as much. There's more car accidents all over the world, 80 times as much. But this is, you know, the fear factor. You got to write a song about it. You know?
I wrote like a joke song about the coronavirus.
No, you didn't.
All my friends are like,
no,
you
didn't.
I did.
No, you didn't.
I did.
See, here I am
Stupid.
Talking. I must have read your mind.
I did.
Oh, that's crazy. That's cool. Okay. And yet it's not out there. You don't use it. You just wrote it.
I'm laughing because my mom is videotaping me right now.
And she's laughing too. Everybody's getting a kick out of this. We're all getting a kick out of this. It's great. It's great.
Maybe I will post the coronavirus song. I don't know.
You have to. You don't
know.
Where it may hit big. You may get 180,000 hits in a couple of days. You don't know. You gotta try it. It's something to do.
Maybe I gotta write. It's only like a few lines. I gotta make it longer.
Yeah, you can do it. I'm sure you can. That would probably sound real good. So we're 32 seconds away from hearing your Smoke and Mirrors song, and I'll put it up here in the studio. We won't go extremely loud, but they're going to be able to hear it out there, but I'm going to take down our mics inside the studio so anybody listening on the radio component, which is audio only, will hear your song, okay? So we'll keep talking,
okay.
But I'm not going to talk during your song. We'll just hear a few things. You and I will talk a little bit here and there, okay?
No problem.
Thank you. If you're tuning into us, we're listening to Emmanuel's song off of Smoking Mirrors. I'm glad you joined us all the way from Florida. Emmanuel is on Zoom. You know, we don't have to see her. And I better watch. I can't touch my face. What is that all about, really? So. This is the clean way to bring them into the studio, I guess, so nobody can touch each other. We are touching each other, which is nice. You're right in our studio, on the backside, on the large, on the large screen behind you, and on my monitor on this side. So, Zoom is a very well way to do it. Get it back on the line on the radio. And then we'll, after about six minutes, let you know if you
It's not me. Don't cry, it's so wonderful. I was
That is Emmanuel Sasson on Smoke and Mirrors. Thanks for joining us here on KUHSDenver.com. And Emmanuel, that was great. What do you think the hook is on that one? I was listening to it. There's a couple of hooks, actually. The part of the song that grabbed you, of course, you know what that means. What do you think it is?
I've got some. It's the Don't Cry. It's always
that's right. You got, yeah. It's like, boom, gotcha. Gotcha. That's what it is right there. It's a boom. And so it's really nice. I really like that song. That's a good one. And so coming
thank
up
you.
Next will be Note to Self, and we're going to talk to Emmanuel a little further before we play that. So Emmanuel, these songs that you're writing, how are you getting inspired? Are you going down by the ocean, or are you just running around the house, watching the
news? Only ocean I have is the pool that's in front of me right now.
Yeah.
But no, all of my songs are based on real life experiences, people that I've met, friendships that I've had, and just everything that goes on in my head, because this head of mine is quite the place. So sometimes I feel like the thoughts in my head should pay rent, but
make them pay rent and raise the rent. Sorry,
yeah.
You're going to have to leave unless you pay a little more. More songs,
but
please.
Yeah, no. Basically, all the dark thoughts in my head, I just write them in terms of songs, so.
That's awesome.
Yeah.
You know, you you play a number of instruments. It says you're multi-instrumental. So what instruments do you play? And I'm sure you have a favorite one in there. You name it. You have a name for it, I'm sure you do.
So first instrument I learned was guitar, then I learned bass, and then piano, and then drums, and then ukulele. And I'm decent at drums.
So you know how to do your triple rattle.
My favorite instrument.
Your double paradiddles. Your flim flams.
I feel like you're testing me here.
Oh no, I'm a drummer too.
Well, I don't know that much. I can keep a beat. Let's just put it
that's
in that
all
way.
That
I'm not. I would not call myself a drummer. But my favorite instrument, I guess, to play would probably be piano. I don't know. I feel like piano just brings a lot of life to every song. You can literally turn any song into a piano version, and it will sound good. So
especially if you play the piano, all the flats and the sharps, and go up and down all the different chords, and they're so nice. I play piano too. So that's why I have to be able to test everybody. Say it is a test. Yes. This is a test of the emergency broadcast system for Emmanuel. That's so sorry. I had to go there.
I love that.
But I keep thinking in my mind right now that you were going to write a song about this virus. So there's all kinds of jokes about it. Everybody's making, everybody's coming up with some great stuff. I'm sure you see all the memes, all the memes. They call memes. I call them memes. So you see
it's
all
okay,
that.
So is my mom.
Does she really? Does she really?
Yeah. She's like, Emmanuel, what is this meme? I'm like, okay.
Yeah, that's what I call them too. Everybody does. Well, here in Denver, it's just the way everybody speaks here. Sometimes some speak in one way, some speak another, so that's just the way it rolls. So you've got to put everything on hold temporarily. So what are you doing in the meantime? You're jamming on the piano, you're playing some songs.
Yeah. Well, I'm working on, obviously the marketing aspects of my career more often, because now I really have the time. And, playing a lot of piano, teaching myself more stuff on piano, and just staying home, really. There's nothing really else to do. My job closed, so.
Did it really?
Did they
say you have to go home, go on unemployment?
Well, I work in a mall, and the mall was closed.
Oh,
so.
Yeah. Malls are fun. That's the thing. You see all kinds of people in the mall. All types.
It depends.
Yeah. All variables.
It can be a little bit annoying.
You can probably really sell your music there. Put your little stand
up.
Or make t-shirts that say, buy your EP now. And then, how to download it and stuff. Say, hey.
Well, sometimes, I go up to people and ask them, hey, do you like indie music? And if they say yes, I'm like, here's my Instagram. And they're like, all right, cool. Sometimes I do it.
We love
to get myself out there.
Yeah, we love indie music here. We have a broadcaster who broadcasts from the northern border in Europe, and he's on tonight.
Mm-hmm.
It's called Indie Rock. So it comes out from the northern border. So You probably don't know, maybe you do know a little bit about KUHSDenver.com. We are all over the world. We have broadcasters that broadcast from Bangkok, Thailand, covering the Asian market, and Peter Hatton out of the northern quarter, covering London, Paris, Germany, Spain, all those areas, broadcasting tonight back this way. Yes, it's different to hear that voice that they have. Thank you, Mike. Thank you. Now it's KUHSDenver. It's just wild. So I'm going to submit some of your music to him, too, so you can broadcast.
Awesome, thank you.
And that goes over over-the-air stations, too. So. But it goes out as KUHS. So right now we got another song coming up, Note to Self. Tell us about Note to Self. You've got about maybe 20 seconds.
All right, really quick. So Note to Self is about something that I struggle with, which is social anxiety. And it's basically self. I'm talking about myself, but the birds and stuff. Thank you.
Why you gotta be like that? Why you gotta be like that? Why you gotta be like that? Why you gotta be like that?
like that. That's note to self. And she's writing a note to herself, and she thought that would be a good song. Isn't that right, Emmanuel?
That is correct.
I'm going to do a big shout out all the way to Athens, Greece, Bangladesh, Buffalo, New York, Belgrade, South Africa, and all the other places that log into us. We are broadcasting to over 100,000 people live right now, and it's nice. We've been around 13 years going KC to Movement. Been around a long, long time, and we're on the forefront of streaming before streaming became streaming. So we've been around a long time. So we've been around, so that's why we want to get you on. I don't know if you've ever heard of BTS, a South Korean group.
Yes.
We were the first radio station to bring them into the United States, and from there on, we got super big. To give you an idea,
that's
what could happen to you. So if somebody, and there's a lot of big people that do listen to this station, and they are big money people that look for talent such as you. So hopefully they grab a hold of your stuff and off you go, and you'll be saying, whoa, I like this. Right?
Thank
but if you,
you
forget
yeah.
about me, Emmanuel,
cool.
If you forget about me, I'll come and look you up. I'll come and find you.
Well,
I say
you
that
already have an idea of where I am. So.
I say that to everybody. You know, so I'm glad you got a hold of me. We almost missed our point here. And we did this in the last, 4 or 5 minutes before it was showtime. And I thank you for being so quick and fast on getting that done. And you had no problem doing it. Just, bam, we were there. So it came through. It's like we were on time. We were just a few minutes. And I knew it. I said, we're going to be at 105. We were about right there. So that happens from time to time. Some of the other bilingual shows we bring in all the way from Mexico. And sometimes they're a little
right.
off on the time. And it happens too. Sometimes we'll go to Canada, or we'll go down to Africa, or if we go up into England or Paris or wherever we're at. Sometimes there's a delay of some sort. Is always the, the Zoom now is a really nice tool to bring in. We don't use it to go live with because we can, but we use the other cameras. We use Zoom to bring in behind us. So you're nice and big for our audience behind you. They can see you back there. It's high def and you look great. Don't worry about a thing.
Thank you.
You look great. So how many is in your family?
I'm sorry?
How many is in your family?
How many? It's just me, my sister, and my parents. That's obviously my direct family, but my grandma has, on my mom's side, has 11 kids, and my mom is the 11th. So you can imagine how many cousins I have. And those kids have 12 kids, and those kids have 12 kids, so I have a
So when it's a party, it's like a giant fiesta.
Oh, yeah. Especially when I visit them in Israel.
Oh, nice.
I get to see all of them.
Oh, how nice.
So.
That is really nice. You ever travel to Israel?
Yeah, I go to Israel twice a year, sometimes once a year. Really depends on the year. But I try to go as much as I can.
And then they're limiting traveling now. That's really bad, but has happened. And so, but that's the way it rolls. You know what I mean? You can't change something. Now, tell me about the color of your hair. Why did you decide on that color? I'm sure you. Wait. I bet you've had green at one time before.
I did not. Actually,
oh, I missed
first time
it.
Dyeing my hair.
Oh, serious? Why did I miss that one? Jesus.
Well, black is my natural color, obviously. Mm-hmm. And, I don't know, since I was like a kid, I just always wanted pink hair. And there's actually a very funny story behind this. I'm going to keep it short though. So I called my best friend and I was like, hey, come over. I want you to dye my hair. She's like, are you sure? I said, yes. I'm having a mental breakdown. Just come over. She's like, all right, I'm coming. So she came over, she bleached my hair. And one thing I didn't know is that it has to be white. Like when you bleach your hair, it has to be almost white for it to be pastel. So I put the pink dye in, and then my hair turned orange. And then I had orange hair for a month. And then I got advice from a stylist, a colorist, and he was like, okay, bleach your hair again at home, and then try again with the pink. And I was like, okay, thank you for your advice. He's like, use the toner. So apparently I don't know how to read, and it wasn't a toner, it was gray hair dye. So I had silver hair for a few days. I went to the colorist. I got the color that I wanted. My hair was a lot darker, but it's fading now. And now it's a pastel pink. so I'm happy with it, but I'm going to grow it out and go back to my natural color.
It looks great like that. I mean, for the stage and for performance and stuff like that, that brings out that stage performance look. And that's, you're very recognizable by that color. Like, you were talking about, what's her name, Billie Eilish. She does the colors with the greens, the reds, and she looks so stylish, and that's what you remember her by. And her songs, and she comes out and delivers her songs just like you're delivering yours. We got another song coming up called Mindful. Tell us about that real quick. And we'll play that.
So I have a friend, her name is Peyton, and she came over a couple of years ago. She struggles with anxiety and OCD, and she's very open about her struggles. And I said, she's also a poet, and I said, hey, tell me, like, do you have a poem about what it's like to, you know, have a panic attack, or because I personally don't experience anxiety at that level, so I was just curious to know, like, maybe I could write a song about it. So I sat in front of my computer, and she was sitting behind me, and she was just talking to me about how she was feeling and about her anxiety. And as she was talking, I was writing down the lyrics to the song, and then I turned it into what it is now called Mindful.
Wow. So we're gonna listen to Mindful by Emmanuel. And now, am I pronouncing your last name correct, Sassoon?
Sasson.
Emmanuel Sasson. And this song is entitled Mindful. We're going to play this song. So you get a big gist of her music. And she told me she's going to go big. I believe her. Listen to this music and you're going to love it. So we're going to take you off of the microphones and go straight to the music. What inspired you to do this song, Emmanuel? What you told me further, right?
Like I said, my friend.
So.
Yeah.
Now, how did she feel about the inspiration?
Well, she actually is very happy about it. I sent her the album when it came out last year. And I asked her, what's your favorite? She's like, our song. I'm like, oh, yeah. Disappointed. That's awesome. So, yes, she's loving it. It's not time. So confused, can't press rewind. I'm slowly losing my mind. Acting in circles, call me crazy. You just joined us, you're listening to the interview with Emmanuel Sasson, all the way from Florida. She's coming out with some great music. She got her EP coming out. She's 18 years old, for kids don't know how old she is. She's doing a very good job of getting her music out there for you. How did Sherry Lay get all the views, and how did you guys connect? Well, my dad actually manages my music for now, and he was on LinkedIn, and he found Sherry on LinkedIn, and they connected, and then now I work with Sherry.
So she knew where to bring you. Yeah, Sherry brings you some quality gift. Thank you, Sherry Lay, for bringing us to Emmanuel. We really enjoy this. We love new artists, of course. Some of the artists don't go nowhere. They just can't take off. Others, like yourself, may take off and you won't come back. You better hang on, because you're in for a rocket ship ride. And that's what happens to some artists. I can't say that'll happen to you. Because we broadcast so far around the world, we're on 40 different platforms. We're not just on the iTunes or those kind of platforms. We're on other platforms that are different in different parts of the world. They have different types of platforms for the entire year. And they carry us, which is nice. Even though they speak a different language, they still listen to American music. And so. That's why we have indie rock. So it's a big, huge network. And like I said, for over 13 years, you can imagine how big it is. And we're still going. And there's 17 shows here, and everybody has their own genre. And of course, I'm glad you got in for this Thursday.
Thank you for having me.
What time is it down there?
Right now, I haven't checked the time, but it should be 2 hours and a half from where you are.
So you're at 3:36
in the afternoon.
Yeah. How's the weather?
Yeah. It's nice, actually. It should be hotter, but it's not. So that's a good thing.
So we're experiencing lots of snow. Of course, you know Denver. Denver, Colorado, the big The Denverites, like, we don't care. Snow don't mess with us. You know, we all have the vehicles to go through a day. We have the snow piled on. Nobody cares. Snow, no big deal. 2 feet of snow, I don't care.
Yeah, so, I've been to Denver before. It's beautiful. Yeah. I love it there.
Were you here with the snow?
Yeah, I was here in September. I don't know if it snowed there. I don't really remember. But it was cold. It was very nice.
The name of the song is Mindful by Manuel Sanson. And if you get it on her download after it's done, I'm going to have her tell you where you can download all her great work. Do not hesitate to download anything you like in this. Everybody who's listening in, help me to do it. And since we're done here, since I can get that. Okay, we're back on the air again. So, okay, where do we get all this fabulous music of yours? Missy Manuel Sassoon.
You can stream all my music on Spotify and Apple Music and on Amazon Music. Pretty much every music platform is there, also on YouTube.
Nice. And they can buy it there?
Yeah, you can buy it on iTunes as well.
Okay, good. Everywhere you can buy Manuel Sassoon's music. And, you know, you have drawn comparisons to everybody, like Florence and The Machine, Billie Eilish, and Halsey. Now, I more or less thought you sounded more like Billie Eilish more than the other ones. But, I mean, some of the songs do sound like the other artists, but in reality, you sound like you. And that's what's nice. You're bringing out a whole different sound, and that's what's cool. If you have a great sound and you stand out, you become a big star. That's the way it works. That's what happened to Billie Eilish. Had that perfect sound that everybody loved, like, whoa, that's some good music. So, what do you have for the future plans? Do you have anything besides? I mean, we know we had to stop all this virus kind of thing, but you do have plans into the future. Do you ever want to tour?
Yeah, for sure. I'm actually planning a tour for this fall. I can't give too much away. But there's going to be a tour, and my new album should be out this summer, hopefully. And if all goes well with the whole coronavirus outbreak, if everybody stays healthy, then everything should go as planned. But for now, yeah, that's the plan. New music and tours.
Awesome. Well, I really thank you for joining us here at the KUHS Denver Studios. We're titled KUHS Denver Radio and TV. We are the stream. You got to listen to the excellent interview with Emmanuel Sassoon all the way from Florida via Zoom, so you can't say I'm infecting anybody, because look it, we're not touching, but we are touching. Hello, Mom.
She didn't know it was a video chat.
This is live. She's being carried live everywhere. She video bombed.
Oh, no.
She video bombed. She's going to see herself in it later. That's fun. You've got to have that. Okay, so thank you for joining us. I'm going to say goodbye for now. I'm going to close down the live feed. You stay on with me for a second. But I'm going to close down the live feed. Thank you for joining us here on KUHSDenver.com. And we're going to continue on some Ed Sheeran. It's a cover by Daniel Shea out of The Other Side of the World. He does a song by Ed Sheeran called Perfect. And this is actually jazz, so hang in. We're going to get going.